You know what's so elegant about this little game, Jake? Nobody knows where the enemy is. They don't even know he exists. He's in every one of their heads. And they trust him. Because they think they are him. Ah, it's beautiful, man. You have to admire the opponent's elegance. Check.
Digo is the worst confidence trickster we could ever figure, we could ever imagine, because you don't see it.
And the single biggest con is, I am you.
The problem is that the ego hides in the last place that you'd ever look, within itself.
It disguises its thoughts as your thoughts, its feelings as your feelings. You think it's you.
People's need to protect their own egos knows no bounds. They will lie, cheat, steal, kill, do whatever it takes to maintain what we call ego boundaries.
People have no clue that they're in prison. They don't know that there is an ego. They don't know the distinction.
At first, it's difficult for the mind to accept that there's something beyond itself, that there's something of greater value and greater capacity for discerning truth than itself.
In religion, the ego manifests as the devil. And of course, no one realizes how smart the ego is because it created the devil, so you could blame someone else.
In creating this imaginary external enemy, we usually made a real enemy for ourselves, and that becomes a real danger to the ego, but that's also the ego's creation.
There is no such thing as an external enemy, no matter what that voice in your head is telling you. All perception of an enemy is a projection of the ego as the enemy.
In that sense, you could say that 100% of our external enemies are of our own creation.
Your greatest enemy is your own inner perception, is your own ignorance, is your own ego.